In this lesson, we're going to create a file system using the Amazon Elastic File System service, Amazon EFS. In the course download, you'll find the Amazon EFS folder, and within that, working with EFS.md. Now, we're going to use the command line interface a bit more in this lesson. So we're actually going to do stuff like creating our security groups and launching instances using the CLI. Now, I've given you the exact commands, so you can literally copy and paste with a few changes that need to be made to add some relevant IDs. So what I'm going to do is copy this first line. We're going to create a security group. It's going to be called Storage Labs, and it will have this description. In the console, I'm going to use the Cloud Shell service. Once Cloud Shell is up and running, paste in your commands, and that's going to create the security group. And the output is simply the security group ID. I need to copy this ID, because we'll see there's a few places in the document where we have security group ID required. So if I highlight this one and then search, I can do a find and replace, and I can replace the security group ID. So now we have the correct ID in place. For our security group, we also need to create an inbound rule. So we can see here the command is AWS EC2 authorize security group ingress, select the name or specify the name, the protocol is TCP, port is 22, CIDR is all zeros. So that allows us to administer our instances. So I can paste this in, and now we should have a rule created for our security group. Next, we need to launch our instances, and you'll see that we need the latest AMI ID. So let's head over to EC2, and this is the easiest way to find the AMI ID. We just click on Launch Instance. We want to choose the Amazon Linux 2023 AMI, select the AMI ID, and then back in the document again, I'm going to do a find and replace, put in the AMI ID. It's just two options here, just two times we need to replace it. And now what I can do is I've got this command to run instances. I've specified the image ID. It's going to launch an instance using that AMI. It's going to be a T2 micro. It's going to be in US East 1A. And I've specified the security group ID. So let's copy this command. Back in Cloud Shell, I'll paste it in. And that's good. That's the output. We get some information. Press Q, the letter Q, and that will take me out of the output. Then I come back and do the same again to launch my second instance. So we just clear the screen. Paste that in, and now we have two instances launched. You can use space to look through the information provided, Q to quit. Now, if I come back to instances here, and these will be running shortly, so I can filter by running. You can see one of them is already up and running, and that one is in US East 1A, as expected. Let's just refresh. In a moment, we'll have our second one as well. There we go. There's the second instance. Four NFS, and that's the protocol we're going to be using to access our file system, we need an additional rule. So you can see here, we've already done a find and replace, so I've got the relevant group IDs in two places. This one is going to allow the NFS protocol from group members because the source is going to be the security group. So I've copied that command back in Cloud Shell, put that command in, and that should have added the rule. We can go back to EC2, go to security groups, find the Storage Lab security group, and in here we can see that we have the two inbound rules, NFS and SSH. The SSH is from anywhere, and for the NFS, it's only from the storage group itself. So that looks good. Now we want to go and create an EFS file system, adding the Storage Lab security group to the mount targets for each availability zone. So back in AWS, let's search for EFS, open up the EFS management console, and let's go and create a file system. We can optionally give it a name, just call it my EFS. I'm going to leave it in the default VPC. Now you can go and customize, there's some more options. Do you want to use the regional file system type or the one zone? Do you want to enable automatic backups? That's the default with lifecycle management here as well. Encryption of data at rest is on by default. And then there's this throughput mode, which you can change based on your requirements. I'm just going to click next and accept the defaults. Now, just to make things faster as well, I'm going to remove the availability zones that I don't need. I only need US East 1A and 1B in my default VPC. I do also want to change the security groups. So I'm going to specify my Storage Lab security group. We can see it here for both of those availability zones. Okay, so now we're going to have mount targets in each availability zone, and this security group is going to allow the access that we need. Here we can add file system policies. We're going to get back to this in a moment. This is a resource-based policy. Let's click on next and then simply scroll down and create the file system. And that's being created. Doesn't take too long, should be available fairly shortly. Here we can see it's in the creating state and it's actually changed while I'm speaking to available. So very, very fast indeed. Now back in this document, what we're going to do is we're going to log into both instances. We're going to do this exact same thing on both instances. Create a mount point, install the NFS client, mount using the NFS client. And there's some values we have to change in here. Create a file on the file system so we can see that we're writing data. Okay, and then we're going to do a few more things. So we'll just do these first few steps first and I'll explain the second pieces. Now, we're using the NFS client. It's just the generic NFS client. We're not using the AWS EFS Utils at this point in time. I'll get back to that shortly. So let's copy the command from line 23. Back in EC2, we're going to connect to each of our instances. So let's select, I'm just going to try and keep these in order so I recognize which is which. US East 1A first, and then US East 1B. Let's connect to that one. Now we're going to run this command. We're going to create the mount point, same on the second instance. Then we're going to install the NFS utils. Again, run this on both instances. Already installed, so there's nothing to do. It's going to be the same on both. That's no problem. Next, we're going to mount using the EFS client. Now here, we do need to change something. This is the file system ID here, and it's obviously not correct. So we need to find our file system ID. Let's go back to EFS. Let's click on, or we've got it actually right here, but you can click on the file system and then copy the file system DNS name. We'll come back and paste that in. Okay, so it's still got the colon slash on the end. I've got two places in my document. I've pasted it in both. Now, this command here, line 27, step 3, I can copy this to my clipboard. And we're going to run this on each instance. And this should mount the file system. There we go. No error means good news. It's done. So let's do the same on the second instance. Now we've mounted the file system. So what we should be able to do is create a file on the file system. So we're going to change directory to the EFS mount point. And then we're going to create some files from each instance. I'll start with the first one. So change directory, and then I probably need sudo for this. So sudo touch instance1.txt. So we see where it came from. Now if I ls, of course, I can see that file. Now let's change directory to the same place on the second instance, and I can see the same file. So now if I sudo touch instance2.txt, of course, both of those exist. And if I ls on both files, both instances, I see the same thing. So we now have two instances and two different availability zones that are sharing the same shared file system. So they can see the same data and they can both read and write at any time. Now what we're going to do is add a file system policy to enforce encryption in transit. And then we're going to unmount and then mount again and see what happens. So we come back to EFS. We are going to go to file system policy, edit. We're going to enable enforce encryption in transit for all the clients and click on save. Then I'm going to run this sudo umount command. That's going to unmount the file system. So I just run that here. And if this happens, you need to change directory. So let's change back into a different directory, sudo umount. You can't do it from the directory you're in. So I'm just going to change directory back to my home directory for this user, tilde. And then I'm going to unmount. Excellent. So now what we're going to try and do is we're going to try and run that mount command again. If I just go back up in my history to find it, sudo mount, access denied. So we can't mount now, which is really interesting. Why can't we mount? The reason we can't mount is because simply the NFS utils do not support this option for encryption in transit. What we need to do instead is we're going to need to install the EFS utils from AWS. So we copy this command, line 36 there. I'm going to come back, run this command, do the same on the second instance as well. So that's just going to install the EFS utils. Then we're going to run this command. Okay, so this is a slightly different command. It's mounting with the type being EFS, and we've got TLS here, so it's going to enable encryption, transport level security. So let's come back to instance in US East 1A, run this command. That worked. Let's find the change directory to the mount point. Here it is, ls, there we go. We've got all the data again. So if I clear screen, mount, it worked. Let's come back, change directory into the EFS mount point, run ls, and I can see the same data. So that's using encryption and transit. So we've now enforced encryption and transit, but we needed to use the EFS utils rather than the regular NFS client. So that's it for this particular lesson. We've run through all those tests. I'm going to terminate these two instances, and then back for my EFS file system, we're going to go back up a level here, select the file system, delete, and then provide the ID for confirmation, and that's it, we're all cleaned up.